Hello students, my name is Shayan Mitra, faculty member of Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management. Today's topic is devices and buses for device networks. So let's go to the next slide. Subject name is Embedded System Design, code is EC703B, and this is the lecture number 9. So let's start. Today we are going to describe the clock features in case of synchronous serial input output, where we use clock signal as to conduct the communication of different kind of data synchronously. So the clock features are: the transmitter does not transmit neither separately nor by encoding using modulation. Both the cases, it will not transmit along with the serial stream of bits any clock rate information in the asynchronous communication. In case of asynchronous communication, the transmitter does not transmit any information, serial stream of bits, any kind of clock rate information will not be shared in case of asynchronous communication. Now next, receiver clock is not able to maintain identical frequency and constant phase difference with the transmitter clock. So depending upon the clock signal that needs to be sent by the transmitter section to the receiver section, according to that the constant phase difference and the identical frequency, constant phase difference is very much similar to it will create that identical frequency. Without the clock pulse or clock signal, the identical frequency will not be maintained. It can't be maintained if we don't provide the clock signal with the serial input, but serial bits, the streaming serial bits. Without that, we can't do that. An example of that is IBM personal computer has two communication. Basically, support a keyboard. Keyboard is basically a communication part that is asynchronous, where after each keyboard splash, we are not sending any clock signal. That's the part. Now, ports, communication ports, COM1 and COM2 at IO addresses. This is the example of the ports. COM1 and COM2 at IO addresses 0.2F80XFF and 0.380XCFF. Handshaking signals are RI, DCD, DSR. We have already discussed all these things in the previous lecture. These are the data bits. RXD and TXD are the receiver end bit and transmitter end bit. These are data bits. The handshaking signals are DCD, DSR, DTR, RTS, CTS and DTR. Let's go to the next slide. Example of communication port and modem handshaking signals. Now, when a modem connects, modem sends data carrier detect signal at an instant at T0. It means at the very moment when the modem connects, it sends the data carrier detect signal, means the DCD signals. Next, communicates data set ready signal at an instant T1 when it receives the bytes on the line. It means it communicates the data set ready signal. It means the data set ready signal is the signal which basically explains itself that the data set is ready. The data set ready signal will be communicated at an instant at T1 when it receives the bytes on the line. As the data carrier has been detected, the DCD signal will send at the instance of T0 by the modem. Now, at the second moment, when the data carrier has been detected, so the carrier which carries the data, now the core data that needs to be communicated, the most important significant data, when the all those bytes of the data bytes are on the line, the data set ready signal at an instance of T1 when it receives, it sends the data set ready signal. And receiving computer terminal responds, the receiving computer terminal responds at an instance T2 by data terminal ready signal. It means if we take it one by one, that data carrier detect signal, basically data carrier detect signal at instance at T0 when it detects the carrier. When the data is in the data bytes are in the serially in the line, the data set ready signal at an instance of T1 will be received. Next, the receiving computer terminal responds at an instance T2 by data terminal ready signal. The receiving part, the receiving computer that is going to receive the data, will respond at instance of T2 by the data terminal ready signal. After the DTR, after the data terminal ready signal by the receiver end, the request to send signal is sent at an instance T3. At the fourth moment, practically at the fourth moment, the request to send signal is sent at an instant. Now the request to send signal, the data, the DTR, the request to send signal, the RTS, after the DTR, the request to send signal will be sent by the receiver end, will be sent from the receiver end to the transmitting. Now the transmitting end will now send the data to the receiving end. How? The receiving end responds by clear to send signal at an instant of T4. Now if you take a very close look, the first thing is the data carrier detect signal. After the data carrier detect signal has been sent at the instance of T0, it means the data is also received, or data is already ready or received or ready. Now at the second instance, it communicates the data set ready signal at an instance of T1 when it receives the bytes on the line. When it receives the bytes on the line, it will send the data set ready signal. Now the receiving computer responds at an instance T2 by data terminal ready signal, and after the data, it will send the signal to the transmitting end. Now the transmitting end will send the request to send signal to send an instance T3. Now after receiving the DTR signal at the receiving end, the receiving end will respond to that RTS signal with the CTS, that clear to send signal according to the instruction of the processor or the processed data or the processed instruction, anything you can see. That after receiving the RTS data, from the receiving end, the CTS signal, the clear to send signal, it means just like a traffic signal, the green light is on, that is the signal. So the clear to send signal will be sent at the instance of T4 to the transmitting. Now after the response CTS, the data bits are transmitted by modem from an instance T5 to the receiver terminal. So this is the whole chronological order of communication port and modem handshaking signal. The first one will be started with data carrier detect signal. Next is communication data set ready signal at instance T1, and third one is data terminal ready signal. After the DTR, request to send signal is sent at an instance T3. The receiving end responds by clear to send signal at an instance T4. After the response CTS, the data bits are transmitted by modem from an instance T5 to the receiver terminal. So this is the continuous process. Between two sets of bytes sent in asynchronous mode, the handshaking signals RTS and CTS can again be exchanged. This explains why the bytes do not remain synchronized during the asynchronous transmission. Between the two sets of bytes sent in asynchronous mode, the handshaking signals RTS and CTS can again be exchanged. It means in case of asynchronous transmission, the request to send, which has been sent by transmitting end to the receiving end, that role can be reversed. It means the receiver end can also send to the transmitting end the request to send signal. So that is the basic reason. That is the reason why the data is not remain synchronized during asynchronous transmission. Let's go to the next slide. Communication protocols. Now these are the basic communication protocols. The previous slide explain how the communication took place according to the processor instruction, and then how the data transferred according to the signal that has been sent from one device to another device. Now the data, communicating segment, the data which transferred from one device to another device, it maintain a specific communication protocol, and the protocol is a standard adopted which tells why. Now according, because why, now we will describe the what kind of protocol, why the protocols are needed to transfer different kind of data from one end to the another end. A protocol is a standard adopted which tells the way in which the bits of a frame must be sent from a device or controller or port or a processor to another device or system. Even in personal communication, we follow a protocol. We say hello, then this is the simple example why we need to maintain a protocol. Now from the next slide, we are going to describe the different kind of communication protocol, which basically according to the device, according to the data, according to the process in which those data is going to be used, according to different kind of accordance for various situation, there are various protocols. Now I will describe all those protocols one by one. First, the protocols are, for synchronous communication, there is HDLC, high level data link control. Now why it is called high level data link control? Because as we know that in case of synchronous communication, the clock signals and the beats are in a sync mode. That's why it's a high level data link control. It means the data consistency will be higher in case of high level data link control. The data we need to send will be received at the receiving end at a very fixed time, or in a very uniform, according to the very the phase difference between the two bytes will be very much uniform. That's why the consistency of the data those are received at the receiving end will be consistent. The structure of the, suppose we have sent 10 data serially and it has numbering. Now when it has been received at receiving end, the numbering and the synchronization of the data, the frame of data is intact. Now that is called data dependence or the data consistency. In some case there is a probability that the data we have sent serially is not received at the receiving end that serially. Probably it could replace one another, so the data consistency will not remain at the receiving end. That's why this is called, in case of synchronous communication, we use high level data link control. Another one is frame relay. For asynchronous transmission from a device port, we use RS-232C, UART, X.25, ATM, DSL, ADSL. All are data subscribe. There are different. These are the example of asynchronous transmission. For networking the physical device in telecommunication and computer networks, Ethernet and token ring protocols used in LAN networks. Internet appliances application protocol and web protocols such as hypertext transfer protocol, secure socket layer, the HTTPS, that is usually we use this. That this protocol has been used in case of web protocols and web search. We will going to see that in a minute. SMT, simple mail transfer protocol, these are the different kind of protocols that we used. Now the file transfer boot protocols in embedded devices network are tele network, file transfer protocol, domain network server, internet message exchange application protocol, and bootstrap protocol. These are the protocols. Wireless protocols in embedded devices networks are LAN, WLAN 802.11, 802.16, Bluetooth, ZigBee, Wi-Fi, WiMAX. These are the examples of wireless protocols in embedded device network. Let's go to the next slide. Exemplary protocols are high level data link control. It is an international standard protocol for the data link network. Used for linking data from point to point and between multiple points, it's a bit oriented protocol. For synchronous communication between two data link layers on a network, this has been used. There are two format standard, HDLC and extended HDLC, for 2^8 and 2^16 destination devices or systems respectively. Next one is exemplary protocol RS-232C for asynchronous communication between two data serial links on a network, between a data communication equipment and a data terminal equipment. RS-232C, a standard protocol used in IBM PC communication port, keyboard, computer, mice, and for the data serial link network in UART bit format. This has been used in case of, this is the example of RS-232C. Next one is UART bits that you have in your syllabus. And what is that? Now UART beads are the protocol. Now we are going to describe how the UART beads work. This is the asynchronous communication protocol. A line non-return to zero energy state. It means an ideal state, the logic state is 1 at the serial length, ideally state. This is the start. A line non-return to zero energy state. It means in ideal state, the logic state is 1. At the serial length, ideal state. That's why it is known as energy state. A non-return to zero. In this kind of state, it means the ideal state, the logic state will be 0. When the state is not ideal, the logic status will be 1. Sorry, the logic status will be 0. In case of ideal state, the logic state will be 1. In case of non-ideal state, the logic state will be 0. Now, compulsory start beat 1 to 0 transition, which receiver detects at the middle of interval T. Compulsory start beat 1 to 0 transition, which receiver end detects at the middle of the beat interval T. Yes. Now, if the beat is the transition of the beat from 1 to 0, the receiver detects at the middle of the beat interval. After start beat, 8 beats transmitted on TXD line or the transmission line and receiver received on RXD line, the receiver line. During period of 8T, receiver detect at the middle of each beat interval T. Because for each beat there will be one clock pulse. Now after each time period of the clock pulse, another beat will be detected. In earlier circuits, the number of data bits could also be set at 5, 6 or 7 in place of 8. One bit is a programmable bit that is optional, present in 11T mode. Now, if the programmable bit is not present, that it will be 10T. And if the P bit, the optional programmable bit, is present, then it will be 11T mode. P bit can be used to detect parity error. It means the programmable bit that has been used is basically used to detect parity error. P-bit can be used to interpret the preceding bytes. P-bit can be used to interpret the preceding byte, not as data but as address or command or parity as per the processing circuit for serial bits at receiver end. Compulsory minimum one stop bit at logic 0. It means the start bit, the stop bit, the programmable bit and the data, the 8 bit, the byte, one byte of information that has been transmitted from TXD line to the received on RXD line. The start bit when the start bit is switching from 1 to 0, during the transition, the receiver detects at the middle of beat interval T, and the 8T is the period time, in that period the data will be sent from receiver end to the transmitting end. In case of programmable bit, that is optional, is used for parity error, to check the parity error. Now, and also there will be a minimum one stop bit at logic 1. Now, the frame of data, the 8 bit, 1 byte has been sent to the receiver. Disconnected serial line logic state is 0. And this disconnected serial line logic state is 0. It means when the 0 state, it will be disconnected. So this is the UART protocol, and according to that protocol, 10 or 11 T time period has been taken to send the data, and 8 bit is the data, the first bit is 1 or the start bit, last is the stop bit, and within that there is a programmable bit that used to check the parity error or detect the parity error. Let's go to the next slide. Examples of internal serial communication device. This one is synchronous peripheral interface port. For example, is 68HC11 and 68HC12 microcontrollers. full duplex synchronous communication, it has these signals: acknowledgement signal MOSI, MISO signals for serial clock for master, output for master and input to master respectively. These are the slave select input for defining an SPI device as slave when SS active. When the slave select is active, the SPI device is worked as a slave. When it is not active, that work probably as a master device. MOSI, this is the one. MISO is at master output and slave input. MOSI is at master output, slave input. Master input, slave output. And this is for clock output at master and input at slave. Output at master and input at slave. This is the 68AC11 and 68AC12 microcontrollers. Now, device selection as master or slave can be done by a signal to hardware input SS, slave select. When 0 pin, then it will work as a master. When slave select is 1 or active, it will work as a slave. If it's not active, it will work as a master. So that is the example of internal serial communication device. Asynchronous UART serial connect interface, SCI, serial connect interface. For example, SCI port in 68AC11/12. UART asynchronous mode port, full duplex port, SCI programmable for transmission and for reception. This is the receiver, this is the transceiver, this is the transmitting control line, this is the receiving control line, and in case of this we use the UART protocol. The UART protocol has been used, it means the data that has been flowing from the transmitting end to receiving end will be in accord with the UART protocol. It means the 11 bit will be sent to the receiver. Asynchronous UART okay. So we will end this. The SDIO function I will describe that in the next lecture. We are going to end this lecture. We will describe this slide and we will end this session together. Okay. The UART asynchronous mode port or full duplex port. This is the AS. And this one is asynchronous UART mode serial interface. This one is serial connect interface, SCI. And this one is serial interface. For example, SI in 805. Now, there is a basic difference. Now, if you take this picture will give you all the explanation. This is for at receiver input from a transmitter output. This at receiver input, these will be same for both of them. Okay. The next one is, now this is the transceiver. This is the transceiver. So from transceiver line it will go to the receiver line. From transceiver line is going to the receiver line. Now, in case of serial interface, it also maintained with the UART protocol. Now, this is a processor and this is also a processor. But in case of this, the UART protocol will not be maintained with this. The configuration is little bit different in both of the cases. This is for receiver and transceiver. And in case of this is for transceiver and it is not in accordance with this one. That's why that from the transceiver end, it is go to the receiver end. And from this transceiver end, this goes to this receiver end. The basic difference is, it also and for UART 10T or 11T mode asynchronous port interface, function as USRT, universal synchronous receiver and transmitter also. And that's why for this asynchronous UART mode for serial interface, which is for SI in 8051, it works as a universal synchronous receiver and transmitter also. SI is therefore synchronous asynchronous serial communication port called USART port. SI is an internal serial input output device in 8051. This is a specific serial interface, basically internal serial input output device for 805. That's why it's different. It has used for 8051 microcontroller. That's why it's a different example where for this, when we use that SI segment, that UART mode has been converted to USART port. That's the point. So we will end this lecture today here, and we will start that from the next. We'll start the other portion will be covered in the next lecture. Thank you.